not only a smart answer, it is actually the answer that must there be. What he's saying is that God for you is a concept, whereas the fellow who is coming to seek help is a fact, and the fact must always be placed higher than the concept. So being an atheist often can mean not believing in the concept of God, and being religious often just means believing in the concept of God. So then being an atheist is just only as bad as being religious, no worse. In fact, in that sense, all mystics are atheists. They don't believe in the concept of God because they don't believe in any concepts. You see, to say that God is unknowable is actually getting very close to atheism. Now you are saying we, or at least now you are being agnostic. Now you are saying we cannot say anything about God. So the Upanishads are all works in atheism, and do you understand this? Are they saying, yes, 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 God is there? Instead of that, they are saying, neither do we know. So how can you say that these are religious things? You remember that when we had said glory to the God that atheists worship? Mm-hmm. Somebody made a poster on that. When an atheist has that experience, then it is real. When the religious man, the so-called religious man, has that experience, it is a very fake thing. Because it is a learned experience, it is a cultivated experience. You already know what to experience. So the real godliness is found only by atheists.
Will have a vision of Buddha.
Yes. You know, to be an atheist means that you are first doing complete neti-neti. So complete that you have negated even God. And only when you have completely cleansed your mind of all concepts, including the concept of God, that you can move into real mysticism now. So first of all, you must be an atheist. Only then you can be really religious. If you think you can be religious by just being religious, then your religiousness is a borrowed religiousness, not your own.
Maybe that's why all the mystic experiences, these different religions are the same. Because when they are really mystic experiences, they go beyond.
They have no religion. They have no religion.
Even if they are
formally, they may be called to, but actually the mystic has no religion. His religion is God.
Sir, the way the word atheism is used popularly in today's world, atheism means to believe in the concept that there is no God.
This is what atheism means.
I believe in the concept that there is no
God. Now this atheism is as bad as religiousness. You see, these two are very different. I believe in no God. And I do not believe in the concept of God. These are not the same. I believe in no God is still a belief. Whereas saying that I do not believe in the concept of God is not a belief anymore. It is a total disbelief in any concept. Since I do not believe in concepts, so I also do not believe in the concept of... Now this is real atheism. then this is total negation. This is what the Upanishads do, neti neti, and this is what Buddha does.
One has to be pissed off
with religion, because religion, instead of becoming the bridge between man and God, is actually the wall between man and God.
And then atheist simply condemns the superstitious belief where everybody else is practically worshipping that wall. That's exactly what Bhagat Singh is also saying. That people are suffering, how can I believe there is a God?
See, you cannot do what Bhagat Singh did without being deeply religious. And it is an instruction in itself that this religious man is saying that I am an atheist. In fact, you must be very boldly able to say that I do not believe in any God, because God is not a belief.
It's relating something in the end, in the same article that you mentioned, Bhagat Singh says that, or it was a part of the book, I'm just confused right now. So he says, the jailer comes to him and he says that you are going to be hanged now. So it's your last day. Why don't you do some worship like now? Remember, he says, you think now I should go and worship the God that I did not agree, so that he would say that now he's scared of death. So it's total.
When the jailer asked him to go worship on his last day, Bhagat Singh could have as well replied, now don't interrupt my worship, please. I have been worshipping since so long. Do you want me to interrupt my worship on this last day? The jailer wouldn't have understood. So Bhagat Singh didn't say. The jailer would have said, what? Throwing the bomb is worship. He said, yes, you break coconuts. Similarly, I threw a grenade. Just a coconut it is.